Aleluya, give God praise. Dale al Señor alabanza. Give him praise. Come on. Give him praise. Give him praise. Lift up the name of Jesus. Dale alabanza. Dale alabanza. Exaltemos el nombre del Señor. Aleluya. That the world and this community would know. Que el mundo y esta comunidad sepa. That the body of Christ gathers in this place. Que el cuerpo de Cristo se reúne en este lugar. A group of people that have been washed by the blood of the Lamb. Un grupo de personas lavado con la sangre de Cristo. Where are the blood-bought redeemers of Jesus Christ? ¿Dónde están los redimidos comprados por la sangre de Cristo? Hallelujah. Come out of your cars for a moment. Salga de su carro. Remember to have your mask on. Acuérdate de siempre usar su máscara. Just turn around and say hi to somebody. Voltéese y salude a alguien. Hallelujah. Tell them welcome to church. Dile bienvenido a la iglesia. Hallelujah. I'm glad to see you. Me alegro verle a ustedes. We are honored to be here today once more. Nos sentimos honrados de estar con ustedes una vez más. Anytime we have an opportunity to gather, cada vez que tengamos una oportunidad para reunirnos, it's not just a gathering, no es simplemente una reunión. It is a demonstration of the power of God in our lives. Es una demostración del poder de Dios en nuestra vida. Demonstration of victory. Una demostración de victoria. We will not allow the enemy to grip us with fear. No vamos a permitir que el enemigo nos se apodere de nosotros con miedo. How many say amen to that? We're going to honor the safety guidelines. Vamos a honrar, amen, la guía de protección, the various steps that we should take, los diversos pasos que deberíamos tomar. But we will worship the Lord. Vamos a adorar al Señor. We will not be imprisoned by the grip of fear. No seremos prisioneros del poder, del miedo y el temor. And I'm honored to see all of you come out here bravely to worship the Lord. Y me siento honrado de verlo ustedes, gloria al Señor, esforzadamente llegar aquí sin miedo para adorar al Señor. Somebody ought to praise God for that. Alguien deberá adorar al Señor por eso. Hallelujah. Today we have something special that we're going to be doing. Hoy vamos a hacer algo muy especial. We're honored to have our director of education and his wife and family. Nos sentimos honrados de tener al director de educación del Distrito Hispano del Este, su esposa y su familia con nosotros. He's going to be bringing the word in a little bit. Él estará predicándonos entre un momentito. Amen. But I'm also honored today to present my granddaughter, dedicate my granddaughter unto the Lord. Hoy también nos sentimos honrados de tener el privilegio de dedicar a mi nieta Clary al Señor. And we're going to be doing that in just a bit. Vamos a hacer eso en un momentito. But I want to present a young lady. Quiero presentar a una jovencita who has been through some difficult times in her life, que ha pasado por momentos difíciles en su vida. I've seen her journey of brokenness. He visto su jornada de quebrantamiento. I've seen how the enemy has tried to destroy her. He visto como el enemigo ha querido destruirla and drag her y arrastrarla. But I've also seen the hand of God upon her life. También he visto la mano de Dios sobre su vida. And how God in his love, y como Dios en su amor, in his mercy, en su misericordia, in his everlasting compassion, y en su compasión para siempre, work in her life, obrar en su vida, in spite of how the enemy has tried to destroy her, a pesar de cómo el enemigo ha querido destruirla. How many know that God still takes what the enemy has tried to use against you and turn it around for the glory of his name. ¿Cuánto sabe que Dios todavía toma lo que el enemigo ha utilizado en contra de nosotros y utilizarlo para la gloria de él? There's a song that says something like that. Hay un himno que dice algo así. Amen. What the enemy used to destroy me, God used to bless me. Lo que el enemigo intentó utilizar para destruirme, Dios lo utilizó para bendecirme. Amen. But it's better lived than sung. Es mejor vivido que cantado. Sometimes we sing things that we don't live. A veces cantamos cosas que no vivimos. But I thank God that we are a church that believes in restoration. Le damos gloria a Dios que somos una iglesia que creemos en la restauración. We believe in God's mercy. Creemos en la misericordia de Dios. We believe in God's grace. Creemos en la gracia del Señor. And if you're here and you don't know Jesus, y si estás aquí y no conoces a Jesucristo, know him today. Conózcalo hoy. He is a God of mercy. Él es un Dios de misericordia. He is a God of grace. Él es un Dios de gracia. I'm honored to share this platform with my daughter Christy. Me siento honrado de compartir esta plataforma con mi hija Christy. And I pray that God may use her at this moment. Pido que el Señor la use en este momento.
Praise God. God bless everybody today. It's been a while, so bear with me. I got a little nervous. But I know that God is in control, and God has a purpose for everything. I'm going to make it quick because I know we're running on time. But first and foremost, I want to thank God for this opportunity. And second, my dad. It's been a long way for me. And a lot of people would think that because I'm a pastor's kid that I have this upper hand and this advantage. And it hasn't been that way for me. And most of my decisions, I've made them on my own. And I can admit and I can humble myself today to accept that I've put myself in certain positions that I've had to then allow God to deal with me in. But it took for me to give everything to him. And that's what today's song is titled, He Wants It All. And it took for me to literally, even right now at this moment, give everything to him. And sometimes we have to drop everything and just run. And not run physically, but spiritually. And I want to dedicate this song to those of you out there that are struggling to give it to the Lord. And I want to dedicate this song to my husband. He's not here today, but I know one day he's going to hear it. And this is a testimony for the both of us. And I hope that this song blesses you guys and that the Lord speaks through me and that it may not be me, but God, first and foremost. Amen.
There's a voice that cries out in the silence, searching for a heart that will love him, longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth, he's searching for a heart that is desperate. He's longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all, he wants it all. He says, love me with your whole heart. He wants it all today. Serve me with your life now. He wants it all today. Bow down. Today, he wants it all today, he wants it all today, so give it all. And there's a God that walks over the earth, He's searching for a heart that is desperate. He's longing for a child that will give him their all. Give it all. He wants it all. And he says, love me. Love me with your whole heart. He wants it all today. Serve me. Serve me with your life now. He wants it all today. Bow down. Today, he wants it all today. He wants it all today. He wants it all of you, more of you, want it all today. All of you, more of you, want it all today.
Amen. How many give praise God for that? ¿Cuánto le dan alabanzas al Señor por eso? I'm going to ask my wife to come, amen, with the girl of the day, amen, Clary Valentina Reyes. Voy a pedirle a mi esposa and the godparents, Daniel and Clary. Amen. My daughter said, I'm going to name it after my mom's best friend. Mi hija dijo, la voy a nombrar después de la amiga mejor de mi mamá, Clary. Amen. There's only two Clarys I know. Hay solamente dos Clary que yo conozco. Clary and Clary. They're right there. They're coming right now. Those are the only two. I've never known anybody else. Yeah. My daughter says it's too hot. And you want me to reply to that? Mi hija dice que hace mucho calor. Yo le digo, ¿quiere que responda eso? How many want me to reply to that? She knows it. She is hotter in hell. Tell somebody it's hotter in hell. Relax. You've been through worse. But here we have the girl of the hour. Aquí tenemos la niña de la hora, Clary Valentina Reyes, our 3-month-old, gorgeous, beautiful, 4 months today. Amen. Granddaughter. Amen. And we have Dan. And Clarita, amen, who are our dear friends. Today they will serve as witnesses. Tenemos a nuestros amigos, Daniel y Clarita, que servirán como testigos y padrinos de esta niña. I'm going to ask my daughter to stand with Dan and Clary. I'm going to ask my wife to come over here, sweetie. Come on, precious. Amen. How about a greeting?
God bless everyone. Dios le bendiga a todos.
Amen. Amen. So this is our first, we had our first Holy Communion maybe a month ago or a little bit more. Tuvimos nuestra primera Santa Cena al aire libre hace como un poquito más de un mes. And today we have our first child dedication. Hoy tenemos nuestra primera dedicación de niños, and none other than my granddaughter y nadie más que mi nieta. Amen. And today we're going to do this unorthodox. Hoy lo vamos a hacer de una manera no tan religiosa. Amen. I want to encourage Christy. Quiero motivar a Christy and let her know that we're honored. And today it's more public than anything. Hoy es más público que cualquier otro momento that we are honored and God has favored us. Nos sentimos honrados. Y Dios nos ha favorecido to be your mom and dad. de ser tu mamá y tu papá. We are blessed. Estamos bendecidos. Amen. To be your mom and dad. We also want you to know that we are not ashamed to be your mom and dad. No solamente somos privilegiados, sino que no nos avergonzamos de ser tu mamá y tu papá. Amen. You're precious in our eyes. Tú eres preciosa a los ojos de nosotros. So just imagine how even more precious you are before the eyes of God. Imagínate aún lo más preciosa que tú eres ante los ojos del Señor. And what God has ordained for your life is a promise. Y lo que Dios ha ordenado para tu vida es una promesa. That means that, you know, God's word cannot come back void. Significa que las promesas de Dios no pueden regresar vacías, sin cumplirse. Regardless of the deserts and valleys that you've been through, no importando los valles y los desiertos que tú has atravesado, what God has promised will come to pass. Lo que Dios ha prometido se llevará a cabo. You continue to do what you sang today. Sigue haciendo lo que tú cantaste en este día. Let that message be your everyday message. Permita que ese mensaje sea tu mensaje diariamente. Give yourself to the Lord. Date por completa al Señor. And you have no idea what God is capable of doing. Tú no tienes idea de lo que Dios es capaz de hacer. Hallelujah. We're honored to be the grandparents of this beautiful young lady. Nos sentimos honrados de ser los abuelos de esta hermosa niña que se parece igualita a su abuelo y a su abuela. Amen. She is beautiful. She looks just like her granddad and her grandmom. Amen. Christy, we encourage you. Christy, te exhortamos to bring up this child in the Lord. Que cría a esta niña en los caminos del Señor. As you're doing with your children. Como está haciendo con tus otros hijos. The most important school in the life of this young lady is your home. La escuela más importante, the first school, la primera escuela, is your home, es tu hogar. Let her see Christ in you. Permita que ella vea a Cristo en ti. That everything that she imitates and emulates, que todo lo que ella vaya a imitar, see, be a reflection of what she has seen in you. Sea reflejo de lo que ella ha visto en ti. Let her see God in you. Permita que ella vea a Dios en ti. And you will see God in her. Y tú vas a ver a Dios en ella. Amen. I thank you for your convictions and values. Te doy gracias por tus convicciones y tus valores. That you understand the importance of dedicating your child unto the Lord. Que tú entiendes la importancia de presentar a tus hijos al Señor. And today we pray y hoy oramos that she can be the next pastor. Que ella pueda ser la próxima pastora of a congregation, de una congregación. The next minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ. La próxima ministro del evangelio de Jesucristo. The next worshiper, la próxima adoradora. The next missionary, la próxima misionera. The next teacher of the gospel, la próxima maestra del evangelio. Regardless of what and where God calls her to, no importando lo que Dios la llama a hacer o a donde Dios la llama, that she can be a light in the midst of darkness, que ella sea luz en medio de las tinieblas, and salt in this earth, y sal a esta tierra. So, the Bible says, la Biblia dice, that they brought the little children unto Christ. Le traían los niños a Jesucristo, in the book of Mark, en el libro de Marcos. And he says that his disciples were rebuking them. Los mismos discípulos los reprendían. But Jesus rebuked them. Pero Jesús los corrigió y los reprendió a ellos, and said, let the children come unto me. Le dijo, dejad los niños venid a mí, and do not hinder them, y no se lo impidáis, because of such is the kingdom of heaven. Porque de los tales es el reino de los cielos. Amen. And this child is innocent. Esta niña está en un estado de inocencia. She belongs to the Lord. Ella le pertenece a Dios. And today we will pray over her life. Hoy oramos sobre su vida. And dedicate her unto the Lord. Y la dedicamos al Señor. I'm going to ask my wife to give me some oil. Ella me va a dar aceite. The Bible teaches that oil symbolizes the Holy Spirit. That's good. La Biblia enseña que el aceite, símbolo del Espíritu Santo. And we pray that as of her early years of life, the beginning years of her life, the Lord may seal her, el Señor la selle, and mark her for the gospel of Jesus Christ, y la marque para el Evangelio de Jesucristo. That any time the enemy and wickedness look towards her, que cada vez que el enemigo y la maldad mire hacia ella, they may see the mark of Christ on her life. Vean las marcas de Cristo sobre su vida, and know that she has been chosen and separated for the gospel of Jesus Christ. Y conozca que ella ha sido separada y escogida como ministro del Evangelio de Jesucristo. This is Clary Valentina. And what I love the best is the last name, Reyes. Alguien dijo que si es Reyes tiene que ser bueno. Amen. She says, not now, granddaddy. I'll get there someday. Let's pray. Will you extend your hands? Vamos a orar. Se atreven a extender las manos hacia acá. Danny, Clary, God couldn't have chosen better witnesses and godparents for this child. And thank you for your friendship. Gracias por su amistad. And thank you, Christy, for selecting a wonderful name to honor your mom and her friendship to her best friend, Clary. Amen. Extend your hands. Let's pray. I'm going to ask my wife, amen, to come. Come on, Grandma. Danny, Gladys, come over, Christy. I want you guys to pray over her. Amen. Yes, Christy. Get over here. Uh-huh. Father, in the name of Jesus, Padre, en el nombre de Jesús, we thank you for this wonderful privilege. Te damos gracias por este hermoso privilegio. To honor you and honor your word, honrarte a ti, honrar tu palabra. As we dedicate this child, mientras dedicamos esta niña, to you, oh God, hacia ti, oh Dios. She belongs to you. Ella te pertenece a ti. And we pray y te pedimos that your grace and your favor be upon her life. Que su favor y tu gracia esté sobre su vida. But we pray for her mom, our daughter. Te pedimos por su mamá, nuestra hija. That you give her favor and grace. Que tú le des favor y gracia. To help this child be nurtured in the ways of Christ, para que esta niña, Señor, sea criada en los caminos del Señor. I pray in the name of Jesus that you bless her with strength. Te pedimos en el nombre de Jesús que tú la bendiga con fuerzas. I pray that she may teach her children to pray. Te pido que ella le enseñe a sus hijos a orar. That she may teach her children your word. Que ella le enseñe a sus hijos la palabra. That she may teach her children to worship. Que ella le enseñe a sus hijos lo que es adorarte a ti, oh Dios. But we pray, Father God, in Jesus' name, te pedimos that you raise a hedge of protection around her and her home. Que tú levantes, Señor, una muralla de protección alrededor de ella y su hogar. Around her and her husband, her marriage. Alrededor de ella y su esposo, su matrimonio. Around this family, alrededor de esta familia. We pray for young Clary. Te pedimos por esta niña. We pray, Lord, that you may bless her. Te pedimos que tú la bendiga. With a powerful ministry, con un ministerio poderoso. With a special calling, con un llamado especial. We pray that she could be a blessing to her community and her home and her church. Te pedimos que ella sea de bendición a su comunidad, su iglesia y, Señor, a todo el mundo. We pray that you use her in a powerful way. Te pedimos que tú la uses de manera poderosa. In the name of Jesus, en el nombre de Jesús, Protect her from all evil. Protégela de toda maldad. Protect her from all wickedness. Protégela, Señor, de todo pecado. Protect her, Father God, in the name of Jesus, from perverted men and women. Protégela de hombres y mujeres perversos. We pray in the name of Jesus that your love and your peace may reign in her heart. Te pedimos que tu amor y tu paz reine en su corazón. And she could be a preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ, y que sea pregonera y predicadora del evangelio de Jesucristo. We are honored to dedicate her. Nos sentimos honrados en dedicarla a ella. In the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. En el nombre del Padre y del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. May she forever, Father God, be covered in your hand. Que ella para siempre sea cubierta por el poder de tu mano. In Jesus' name, en el nombre de Jesús. Amen. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. Dios le bendiga. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Pastor David, Pastor Dan, come on, Danny. Danny, come on, brother. Let's receive with a strong clap offering or a sounding of your horn. Recibamos con un aplauso fuerte o el sonido. Hold on a second, Dan. We have a mic for you. We have a mic for Pastor Dan. Amen. Okay. Then we'll just use this mic. Amen. And we'll call it the day. Hallelujah. Usamos este micrófono. Amen. Y finalizamos después del mensaje. Yes.
Amen. Amen. ¿Cuántos pueden adorar al Señor en esta tarde? Siento que hay ángeles que han sido asignadas a esta área, a esta.
I believe there are angels.
Siento como que la presencia del Señor ha inundado esta zona, este parqueo.
I believe that there are angels that have overwhelmed this parking lot.
Y yo no sé usted en esta tarde.
I don't know about you this afternoon.
Y hay muchas restricciones que nos han puesto.
There's a lot of restrictions that were given to us.
Pero nada nos podrá restringir de alabar y glorificar el nombre del Señor.
But nothing can hinder us from worshiping the Lord.
Podemos alabar a Dios en esta tarde.
We can worship him this afternoon.
Come on, suene tu bocina en esta tarde.
Come on, sound your horn
y deje
this
que
afternoon.
Esta comunidad sepan esta tarde.
And allow this community to know this
que
afternoon.
Hay un Cristo que reina y que vive para
that
siempre.
There is a Christ that reigns and lives forever.
Y que su nombre es digno de ser adorado.
And his name is worthy of being worshiped.
No hay nadie más grande que nuestro Dios.
Nothing is greater than our God.
Que lo oiga todo West Haven en este
Let
día.
Let West Haven hear it today.
No importa lo que venga.
It doesn't matter what comes our way.
Nada nos podrá impedir bendecir el nombre del Señor.
Nothing can hinder us from declaring the name of God.
Porque él ha sido bueno con nosotros.
For he has been good with us.
Porque su misericordia son nuevas todas las mañanas.
Because his mercies are new every morning.
Y donde está el Espíritu de Dios.
And where the Spirit of the Lord is.
Allí hay libertad.
There is freedom.
Declaro que hay libertad en este lugar.
I declare freedom in this place.
Para bendecir el nombre del Señor.
To worship the name of the Lord.
Para predicar esta palabra en esta tarde.
To preach this word this afternoon.
Para anunciar el evangelio de Jesucristo.
To announce the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Oh, yo sé que no estamos dentro del templo.
I know we're not inside the temple.
Pero este lugar se ha convertido en esta tarde.
But this place this afternoon
se ha convertido en casa de Dios.
Has become the house of God.
Y puerta del cielo.
And door of heaven.
Este es el lugar.
This place
donde la presencia del Señor
is where the presence of God
está corriendo y fluyendo como un río.
It's flowing as a river.
Porque se está predicando la palabra del Señor.
Because we're preaching the word of God.
Les saludo a todos en esta preciosa tarde.
I greet you all in this wonderful afternoon.
Al nombre de nuestra familia.
On the name of our family.
Mi amada esposa.
My wife.
Reverenda Clarita.
His wife Clarita,
el cuerpo ejecutivo,
the executive body of the Spanish Eastern District,
y el departamento de educación les extiende un caluroso saludo a cada uno de ustedes.
And the Department of Education, we extend a cordial greeting.
I kind of like the way this feels.
Me encanta cómo esto se siente.
I know sometimes when we're in the tabernacle, there's some limits.
A veces cuando estamos en el tabernáculo, pues hay ciertas limitaciones.
But here there's no limits.
Aquí no hay límite.
Here no one has to tell you you're talking too loud.
Aquí nadie te tiene que decir estás hablando mucho.
Or you're shouting too hard.
O estás gritando muy duro.
Some of us are in our cars.
Algunos están en los carros.
Some of us are standing outside.
Algunos están afuera de sus carros.
I don't know in what way you're going to worship God.
Yo no sé en qué manera usted le va a adorar.
But don't lose this opportunity.
Pero no pierde esta oportunidad.
To bless the name of the Lord.
Para adorar el nombre del Señor.
I came to have church today.
Yo vine a tener un curtazo
en
este
día. In my car or out of my car.
En mi carro o fuera del vehículo.
With my mask or without a mask.
Con la careta o sin la careta.
I came to have church.
Yo vine a adorar a Dios.
I came to bless the name of the Lord.
Yo vine a celebrar el nombre del
Señor.
And
I want to deposit this word here today.
Y quiero depositar esta palabra aquí en este día.
I know that the time is running.
Yo sé que el tiempo corre.
But there's a word that God has given me for you today.
Hay una palabra que el Señor me ha dado para usted en este día.
Y quiero compartirla rápidamente.
I want to share it quickly.
Yo sé que el tiempo avanza.
I know that time is running.
It's found, se encuentra en una carta muy hermosa.
It's found in a special letter.
A una iglesia una iglesia en la ciudad de Colosa.
A church in the city of Colossae.
Es la carta a los Colosenses.
It's the letter to the Colossian church.
En el capítulo 3,
chapter 3,
creo que el apóstol Pablo nos da un gran consejo.
I believe that the apostle Paul gives us a great advice.
Por más de 2000 años, casi 2000 años atrás.
Almost 2000 years ago.
Todavía esta palabra sigue siendo una palabra para nosotros.
This word continues to be a word directed towards us.
Y con todo lo que estamos pasando.
And with everything that we are facing.
Y con todo lo que vamos a pasar.
And everything that we will face.
La verdad es que no sabemos lo que se acerca.
We truly don't know what's ahead of us.
Pero quiero depositar esta palabra.
But I want to place this word
para motivarte en esta tarde,
to motivate you this afternoon,
para fortalecerte en este
to
día,
strengthen you on this day,
para prepararte para posiblemente lo que viene,
to prepare you possibly for what's to come,
con un consejo de un gran hombre de Dios,
with a counsel from a great man of God.
Y él nos dice,
and he says,
si pues habéis resucitado con Cristo,
if you have then been raised with Christ,
buscar las cosas de arriba,
seek the things that are above,
donde está Cristo sentado a la diestra de Dios,
where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
Poner la mira en las cosas de arriba.
Set your minds on the things that are above,
no en las de la tierra,
not on the things that are on the earth,
porque habéis muerto,
for you have died,
y vuestra vida está escondida con Cristo en Dios.
Your life is hidden with Christ Jesus in God.
Y cuando Cristo,
and when Christ,
vuestra vida se manifieste,
who is your life, appears,
entonces vosotros también seréis manifestados con él en gloria.
Then you also will appear with him in glory.
Hay una alarma que está sonando en este tiempo.
There is an alarm that is sounding loudly during this time.
Y está despertando a la iglesia con el propósito para tres cosas.
And it's awakening the church for three purposes.
Lo voy a decir otra vez.
I'm going to say that again.
Lo que hemos pasado durante los últimos 5 a 6 meses.
What we have been facing for the last 5 to 6 months.
Ha sido una alarma para nosotros.
Has been an alarm towards us.
Ha sido una alarma para despertarnos.
It has been an alarm to awaken us.
Para cumplir con el propósito que Dios tiene para nosotros.
To fulfill the purposes that God has for us.
Hay algo que Dios quiere hacer con nosotros a través de toda la pandemia que hemos pasado.
There is something that God wants to do in all of us through this whole pandemic.
Y hay tres cosas que quiero hablarles en esta tarde.
And there are three specific things that I want to mention.
Lo primero que queremos hacer, que Dios quiere hacer en este tiempo,
the first thing that God wants to do during this time,
es que Dios quiere reiniciar.
God wants to reset.
Come on, diga conmigo, reiniciar.
Say it with me, reset.
¿Reiniciar qué?
Reset what?
Si hay algo que debemos hacer en este tiempo,
if there is something that we should do during this time, time.
Dios quiere reiniciar nuestra relación con él.
God wants us to reset our relationship with him.
Que podamos volver al primer amor.
That we could return to our first love.
Que podamos volver a nuestra primera adoración a Dios.
That we can return back to worship unto God.
Christy acaba de cantarlo.
And Christy just sang it.
Esto se trata de una entrega.
This is about surrendering.
Esto no solamente se trata de venir a la iglesia.
This is not just about coming to church.
Esto no se trata de solamente estar sentado en nuestro carro.
It's not about being seated in a seat in a car.
Es asegurar que nuestra vida y todo lo que tenemos.
It's making sure that our lives and everything that we have.
Está siendo entregado al Señor.
It's being given unto the Lord.
Dios, como dijo ella, lo quiere todo.
God, as she said, he wants it all.
Y yo te invito en esta tarde.
And I invite you this afternoon.
Abrir tu corazón.
To open up your heart.
Y abrir tu boca.
And open your mouth.
Y sonar tu bocina.
And sound your horn.
Y entregárselo todo al Señor.
And give it all unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Él merece lo mejor.
He deserves the best.
Él merece todo.
He deserves it all.
Es importante.
It's important.
Que nos reenamoremos con Cristo.
That we fall in love again with Jesus Christ.
Say this again.
Lo voy a decir de nuevo.
Es importante nosotros reiniciar nuestra relación con Dios.
It's important that we reset our relationship with God.
No permita que en esta tarde.
Don't allow this afternoon.
Yo sé que no es muy cómodo tener que alabar a Dios con una mascarilla.
I know it's not too comfortable to praise him with a mask on.
Pero después que la mascarilla no esté sobre tu corazón.
But as long as the mask is not on your heart.
Eso es lo más importante.
The important thing.
Podrán poner una mascarilla sobre mi boca.
They can put it over my mouth.
Pero no podrán poner una mascarilla sobre mi alma.
They can't put it over my soul.
Mi alma le pertenece a Dios.
My soul belongs to God.
Mi corazón le pertenece al Señor.
My heart belongs to God.
Reinicia tu relación en esta tarde.
Reset your relationship this afternoon.
Este es un momento para comenzar de nuevo.
This is a time to start all over again.
Este es un tiempo para quizás cambiar y romper las rutinas.
This is a time to break the routine.
Es posible que nosotros hemos entrado en un tiempo de muy rutinaria.
It's possible that we have entered a time of routine.
Quizás la iglesia por un tiempo había entrado en un tiempo rutinaria.
Maybe the church for some time has been living on a routine.
Donde veníamos a la iglesia.
When we would come to church.
Y entramos de una forma.
We would go in one way.
Y salimos de la misma forma.
And we would walk out the same way.
Pero Dios está cansado de eso.
But God is tired of that.
Dios quiere algo mejor.
God wants something better.
Dios lo quiere todo.
He wants it all this afternoon.
Reinicia tu relación.
Reset your relationship with God.
Reinicia tu relación con el Señor.
Reset your relationship with God.
Y reenamórate con Cristo.
And fall in love with him all over again.
Pero hay otro propósito por esta pandemia.
But there's another purpose of this pandemic.
Y la segunda razón.
The second reason.
Creo que Dios quiere hacer con nosotros en este tiempo.
I believe that God wants to do in us today.
Es que Dios quiere restaurar.
He wants to restore.
¿Restaurar qué?
Restore what?
Restaurar nuestra relación. Familiares.
Restore our family relationships.
Me atrevo a decir en esta tarde,
I want to tell you this afternoon
que si hay algo que Dios quiere hacer,
that if there's something that God wants to do,
es restaurar nuestras casas.
It's restore your homes.
Porque vengo a decirle a alguien esta tarde,
because I've come to tell somebody today,
que no solamente se sirve a Dios dentro del templo,
you don't just serve God in the temple.
El Espíritu Santo quiere moverse dentro de nuestras casas.
God wants to move in your homes.
Dios quiere restaurar nuestros hogares.
He wants to restore our homes.
Para que sea un lugar de adoración.
So that our homes can be a place of worship.
Para que sea un lugar de enseñanza.
So that it can be a place of teaching.
We can't just stay teaching the gospel in the church.
No solamente podemos enseñar el evangelio en la iglesia.
Yo creo que en este tiempo.
I believe during this time.
Dios está restaurando nuestras casas.
God is restoring our homes.
Está restaurando el hogar.
He's restoring our houses.
Porque es allí donde el amor de Dios.
Because it is there where the love of God.
Se refleja en su totalidad.
Is reflected in its totality.
COVID-19 no ha forzado a todos a pasar más tiempo en casa.
COVID-19 ha provocado que muchos se queden en sus hogares.
Y nos ha obligado a mejorar nuestra relación matrimonial.
It's obligated for us to look at and restore our marital relationship.
Nuestra relación con nuestros hijos.
Our relationship with our children.
Vengo a decirte en esta tarde que no hay nadie que te conoce mejor después de Dios que tu familia.
Nobody knows you better after God than your own family.
Me atrevo a decir que no hay nadie que te ama. ama más que tu familia.
I dare say that no one loves you more than your own family.
Qué lindo verlos en esta tarde congregados por familia.
How beautiful it is to see you congregated by family.
Oiga, si su esposo o sus hijos están a su lado, dile en esta tarde te amo.
If you have your spouse beside you, tell them I love you.
Salmo 133 dice lo siguiente.
Psalms 133 says,
mira cuán bueno y cuán delicioso es.
Look how good and delicious it is.
Habitar los hermanos,
for the brothers to gather,
y me atrevo a decir nuestras familias,
and our families,
juntos en armonía,
together in harmony.
Vengo a decir que este lugar,
I've come to say that this place,
me atrevo a decir que esta iglesia,
I dare say this church,
se está preparando para algo mayor,
is preparing itself for something greater,
porque Dios está restaurando familias,
because God is restoring families,
está restaurando matrimonios,
he's restoring marriages,
porque allí envía Jehová,
because there God sends,
bendición y vida eterna.
Blessings and eternal life.
¿Cuántos quieren bendición?
How many want blessings?
¿Y cuántos queremos vida eterna?
And how many of us want everlasting life?
Lo que produce bendición,
what produces blessings,
y lo que produce vida eterna,
and what produces everlasting life,
es una palabra que se llama armonía.
Is a word that's called harmony.
Dios quiere que vivamos en armonía.
God wants us living in harmony.
Dios quiere que vivamos en armonía con nuestra comunidad.
God wants us in harmony with our community.
Oiga, no importa el color que usted sea.
It doesn't matter what color you are.
No importa cómo usted se ve en esta tarde.
It doesn't matter what you look like today.
No importa qué nación usted viene.
It doesn't matter what nation you're from.
Si tú eres lavado con la sangre de Cristo,
if you're washed by the blood of the Lamb,
tú eres mi hermano, mi hermana.
You're my brother, you're my sister.
Y aunque tú quizás no se le sirva al Señor,
and maybe even if you don't serve the Lord,
tú eres un ser humano.
You are a human being.
Y tú mereces experimentar el amor de Dios.
And you deserve to experience the love of God.
No hay tal cosa como prejuicio dentro de la iglesia.
There is no such thing as a prejudice in the church.
No importa de dónde tú eres.
It doesn't matter where you're from.
Sea de la República Dominicana.
Whether you're from the Dominican Republic.
Sea de Puerto Rico.
Whether you're from Puerto Rico.
Sea de Centroamérica.
Whether you're from Central America.
Sea de África.
Whether you're from Africa.
Sea de donde sea.
Wherever you might be from.
Somos una gran familia.
We are one great family.
Dios está restaurando nuestra familia.
God is restoring the family.
Está restaurando nuestras comunidades.
He is restoring the community.
Y aunque el enemigo ha querido destruir esta nación,
and although the enemy has wanted to destroy this nation,
nosotros tenemos la respuesta.
We have the answer.
Cristo nos dio la respuesta.
Jesus gave us the answer.
Cuando le preguntaron cuál es el mandamiento mayor,
when they asked him what is the greatest commandment,
él dijo amarás a tu Dios.
He said you shall love your God.
Y amarás a tu prójimo.
And you shall love your neighbor.
Si aplicamos esas dos verdades,
if we apply those two truths,
se termina el racismo en esta
racism
nación.
Will be over in this nation.
Se termina las divisiones de las
division
comunidades.
Division will be over in the communities.
Hay que amar a nuestro prójimo.
We have to love our neighbor.
Pero hay otro, un tercer punto.
But there's a third point.
Este tiempo nos ha ayudado para reiniciar nuestra relación.
This time has helped us to reset our relationship with God.
Y también nos ha ayudado a restaurar nuestra relación familiar.
And it has helped us to restore our family relationships.
Pero hay un tercer punto.
But there's a third point here.
Y Dios quiere que tú y yo redescubramos quiénes somos.
He wants us, God desires for us to rediscover who we are.
I think we were losing our way.
Yo creo que hemos estado perdiendo nuestro camino.
We got caught up with so many other things that really weren't that important.
Nos envolvimos en tantas otras cosas que no eran tan importantes.
Maybe we got too caught up with just the program of ministry.
Tal vez no hemos envuelto tanto en los programas ministeriales.
Maybe we got caught up with just the appearance of coming to church.
Tal vez nos envolvimos en la apariencia de llegar a la iglesia.
And we forgot who we are.
Y nos olvidamos quiénes éramos.
Let me remind you who you are.
Déjame
today.
Recordarte quién tú eres.
Quiero recordarte por la palabra que dice Dios quién tú eres.
I want to remind you through God's word of who you are.
Número uno, tu identidad es esta.
Your identity is this.
Tú eres resucitado con Cristo.
You are resurrected in Christ.
I'm
to say that again.
Lo voy a decir de nuevo.
Tú y yo hemos sido resucitados con Cristo.
You and I have been resurrected with Jesus Christ.
Ya no vivo yo.
I no longer live.
Ahora vive Cristo en
but
mí.
But now Christ lives in me.
Implica que yo, tú y yo hemos sido crucificados.
It implies that you and I have been crucified.
Que ya nuestro pasado fue enterrado.
That our past has been buried.
Fue sepultado.
It has been buried.
Y ahora nosotros hemos sido resucitados
con Cristo.
And now
we have been resurrected with Jesus.
Hemos muerto a la vieja manera de vivir.
We have died to our old way of living.
Y ahora hemos sido resucitados a una nueva vida.
And we've been resurrected to a new life.
Yo vengo a decirle a alguien esta tarde.
I've come to tell somebody that today.
Que tú y yo no somos cualquier cosa.
That you and I are not just anything.
En un tiempo estábamos muertos.
There was a time where we were dead.
Pero en esta tarde podemos levantar nuestras voces.
But this afternoon we can raise our voice.
Y decir Cristo vive.
And say Jesus lives.
Cristo vive.
Jesus lives.
Cristo vive.
Jesus lives.
Porque él vive dentro de mí.
And because he lives inside
porque
of me.
Porque lo siento dentro de
because
mi corazón.
Because I feel him inside my heart.
Porque lo siento dentro de mi ser.
I feel him inside my soul.
Y como él vive.
And because he lives.
Tengo que cumplir con el segundo punto.
I have to fulfill this next point.
Es que tenemos que cumplir con nuestro propósito.
We have to fulfill our purpose.
Pablo dice a la iglesia de Colosa.
Paul told the Colossian church.
Y se lo digo a ustedes también esta
and I
tarde.
Tell you today this afternoon.
Y quiero que me pongan atención.
And please pay attention.
Ya estamos terminando.
We're almost done.
Pon atención.
Pay attention.
Porque estamos tú y yo para entrar en una temporada como nunca.
We are about to enter into a season like never before.
Estamos esta nación está pasando por una crisis muy, una crisis espiritual.
This nation is going and enduring through a spiritual crisis.
Donde hay muchos que están confundidos.
Where many are confused.
Donde han perdido sus valores.
They have lost their values.
Y han perdido lo que realmente es importante.
And they have lost or overlooked what's really important.
Pero vengo a decirle a alguien esta
but
tarde.
I've come to tell somebody this afternoon.
Mientras que muchos están mirando a la izquierda.
While many are looking to the left.
Y otros están mirando a la derecha.
And others are looking to the right.
Yo no sé de qué lado tú eres.
I don't know what side you're on.
Puede ser del lado izquierdo.
You might be on the left side.
O el lado derecho.
Or you might be on the right side.
Pero el creyente no existe de esa forma.
But the believer cannot live that
no
way.
No está a la derecha ni a la izquierda.
You are neither to the right nor to the left.
Sino nuestra mirada es arriba.
But our eyes have to be placed on heaven.
Pablo dice hay que buscar las cosas
Paul
de arriba.
Said we must look to the things of above.
Hay que buscar lo que está arriba.
We must look to the things of heaven.
Hay muchos que están dependiendo del gobierno para la solución.
Many are depending on the power of the government for the solution.
Hay muchos que están dependiendo quién va a llenar la Casa Blanca.
Many are asking who's going to fill the seat in the White House.
Y se han olvidado.
And they have forgotten.
Que no importa el que esté en la Casa
that
Blanca.
It doesn't matter who's seating in the White House.
Hay uno que está a la diestra del Padre.
There is one seated at the right hand of the Father.
Hay uno que está en el trono.
There's one on the throne.
Él es el Rey de Reyes.
He is the King of Kings.
Y el Señor de Señores.
And Lord of Lords.
Yo no sé a quién tú le sirves en esta tarde.
I don't know who you're serving this
pero
afternoon.
Pero yo le sirvo a Cristo.
But I serve Jesus.
Él tiene toda la autoridad.
He has all authority.
Él tiene todo el dominio.
He has all dominion.
Él tiene todo el poder.
He has all power.
¿A quién tú estás buscando?
Who are you seeking?
¿Sabe que esa palabra buscar?
You know that power seek.
Muchas
that
veces
word seek.
La malentendemos.
We misunderstand it.
¿Cuántos de nosotros hemos mandado a alguien a buscar algo en las casas?
How many of us have sent someone to seek something?
Buscar algo en una gaveta.
Seek something in a drawer.
Y luego la persona regresa y dice, no lo encontré.
And somebody, that person comes back and says, I didn't find it.
Y luego tú tienes que volver y buscarlo tú mismo.
And then you have to go and seek for it on your own.
Porque hay una diferencia.
Because there's a difference.
Cuando tú buscas para encontrar.
When you seek to find.
Y tú buscas solamente para cumplir.
Or you seek to fulfill.
Yo no vine para cumplir en esta tarde.
I didn't come to fulfill this afternoon.
Yo vine a buscar con todo mi corazón.
I came to seek with all of my heart.
Jeremías decía, Job, y me buscaréis y me hallaréis.
Jeremiah said, you will seek me and you will find me.
Porque me busques de todo vuestro corazón.
Because you've sought me with all of your heart.
Alguien que ha venido a buscar al Señor con todo su corazón.
Is there someone seeking the Lord with all of their heart?
Alguien que pueda decir en esta tarde.
Is there someone who can say this afternoon?
Yo no voy a perder mi tiempo.
I'm not going to waste my time.
Yo voy a buscar a Dios.
I'm going to seek God.
Porque de él viene mi socorro.
Because from him comes my strength.
Mi socorro viene de Jehová.
My strength comes from the Lord.
Que hizo los cielos
y
la tierra.
Who created the heavens and the earth.
Mientras más yo busco,
the more I seek him.
¿Sabe lo que sucede?
You know what happens?
Más se aparta el enemigo.
The enemy departs even more.
Para destruir mi vida.
To destroy my life.
I'm going to say that again.
Voy a decirlo de nuevo.
Yo digo, yo sé que algunos piensan que cuando más yo busco al Señor,
I know that some think that some might think that the more you seek the Lord,
más se presenta el enemigo para destruir.
The enemy comes more to destroy me.
Pero lo que no entendemos,
what we don't understand,
es que nosotros no vivimos esta vida,
we don't live this life,
de acuerdo a nuestra forma de pensar,
according to the way we think,
sino la vivimos de acuerdo a la palabra del
but
Señor.
We live it according to the word of God.
Si yo busco a Dios,
if I seek God,
el que busca al Señor,
those who seek the Lord,
Satanás tiene que huir,
the devil has to flee,
tiene que huir en esta tarde,
he has to flee this afternoon,
buscar primeramente el reino de Dios,
seek first the kingdom of God,
y su justicia,
and his righteousness,
y las demás cosas vendrán por añadidura,
and all things will be added to you,
nuestra identidad,
our identity,
nuestro propósito,
our purpose,
hay que redescubrirla,
we have to rediscover it,
quiénes somos,
who are we,
pero por último,
and lastly,
tenemos que entender nuestro destino,
we have to understand our destiny,
somos resucitados con Cristo,
we are resurrected with Jesus,
debemos buscar de Cristo,
we want to seek Jesus,
oiga, no importa cómo las cosas se ven,
it doesn't matter what things look like,
busquemos al Señor,
let's seek the Lord,
porque nuestro destino,
because our destiny,
es el cielo,
is heaven,
cuando Cristo vuestra vida se manifieste,
with Jesus our life is manifested,
entonces vosotros también seréis manifestados con él en gloria,
and then we will also be manifested with him in glory.
Yo no sé cuándo será la venida del Señor.
I don't know when the coming of the Lord shall take place.
Puede ser que después que terminemos este culto,
it's possible that when we're done after this service,
los cielos se puedan abrir,
the heavens can be opened,
la trompeta puede sonar,
the trumpet can sound,
y nos vamos con el Señor,
and we go with the Lord.
Pero te pregunto en esta tarde,
but I ask you this afternoon,
si este fuera el último culto,
if this were to be the last service,
si este fuera el último sermón,
if this was the last message,
¿qué vas a darle a Dios en esta tarde?
What will you give unto the Lord this
para
afternoon?
Preparar tu corazón,
to prepare your heart,
para la venida del Señor,
for the coming of the Lord.
Porque tú y yo un día seremos levantados.
Because you and I, one day we shall be raptured.
Ese es nuestro destino.
That's our destination.
Este mundo es temporal.
This world is temporary.
Pero un día Cristo nos levantará.
But one day we will be lifted with the Lord.
Levante su mano al cielo.
Raise your hands unto the Lord.
Levante su mano al cielo.
Raise your hand unto the Lord.
Y dile al Señor en esta tarde.
And say, Lord, this afternoon.
Allí donde estás sentado.
Right there where you're seated.
Señor, te entrego mi corazón.
Say, Lord, I give you my heart.
Te entrego todo lo que soy.
I surrender all that I am.
Señor, en esta tarde.
Lord, this afternoon.
Someto todo lo que soy.
I submit all that I am.
Ante tu presencia.
Before your presence.
Ayúdame, Señor.
Help me, Lord.
A buscarte hoy más que
nunca. To seek you today more than ever.
A entregarte hoy más que nunca.
To surrender myself more than ever.
A estar preparado hoy más que nunca.
To be prepared today,
Padre,
more than ever.
Mira las manos levantadas ahora mismo.
Father, look at the hands that are raised before you.
Aquellos que están sentados en los carros.
Those who are seated in their cars.
Que han escuchado tu palabra.
Those who have listened to your word.
Y han entendido que en este tiempo.
And have understood that in this time.
Este es el tiempo de estar preparado.
This is the time to be ready
para la venida del Señor,
for the coming of the Lord.
Señor, toca sus corazones.
I pray that you touch their hearts, Father.
Pon ansia de servirte.
I pray that you put a desire to serve.
No permita, Dios mío, que nos descarriemos en estas últimas horas.
Do not allow us to fall away during these last days.
Sino que podamos afirmar nuestros pasos, nuestros caminos contigo.
Help us to strengthen our relationship with you.
Y estar preparado.
And be prepared
para tu hermosa venida.
For your wonderful coming.
Gracias te damos.
Thank you, Father.
Por tu palabra.
For your word.
Gracias por esta reunión.
Thank you for this meeting.
Gracias por cada creyente.
Thank you for every believer.
Gracias, Señor.
Thank you, Lord.
Por tu palabra.
For your word.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Te lo pedimos todo.
We ask this all.
Amén.
Amen.
Y amén.
God bless you. God keep you. Dios le bendiga. Dios le guarde. We'll see you next Sunday. Nos vemos el domingo que viene. We love you. Les amamos. Remember, surrender it all. Acuérdese, ríndelo todo al Señor.